On 13 January, two Kazakh rangers were on their usual patrol when they saw something strange, fresh car tracks in the remote uninhabited steppe. This could mean only one thing: poachers. Yelen Naglev and Peter Natsik quickly gave chase, firing warning shots to stop the cars speeding away. When the car stopped, armed men got out. The rangers were badly beaten up, trying to arrest the criminals. Mr. Naglev died in hospital 2 days later. This is the first time in the history of Okotrupram, the agency that protects Kazakhstan's wildlife, that poachers have killed a state ranger. Mr. Naglev's death has caused a huge outcry, with many people urging authorities not to let the criminals get away with this murder. The prosecutor general is personally overseeing the investigation of this case, but this incident has also exposed how massive poaching has become. The poachers who escaped and left the injured rangers in freezing cold were hunting Saiga ice age antelopes that existed back in the days of woolly mammoths. Kazakhstan is home to the largest population of Saiga in the world. The International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN, included these animals in its red list of critically endangered species. It is a criminal offense to hunt Saiga antelopes in Kazakhstan. Poaching was one of the main reasons why their population dropped from more than 1 million in the early 1990s to just about 20,000 a decade later. Today, thanks to conservation projects and anti-poaching measures, the Saiga population in Kazakhstan has increased to about 200,000. But illegal hunting remains one of the major threats to these animals. Poachers are ready to take any risk, as the reward is very lucrative. Just 1 kilogram, 2 pound, of Saiga horn, used in Chinese traditional medicine, may fetch several $1,000s. I met Mr. Naglev and Mr. Nitsik last May, like on the day of the fatal incident. They were on a shift protecting the wildlife. We talked a lot about their work, about poachers who are often better equipped than rangers and can successfully escape when chased. Mr. Nitsik showed his Makarov handgun when explaining about chasing poachers. I have only used it for warning shots, never against humans, he said. On that tragic day, they used their weapons again only for warning. They had every right to shoot criminals, since their lives were under threat, their colleagues say, but they probably did not realize how serious the threat was until it was too late. They had far many. The death of Mr. Naglev has become a symbol of injustice in Kazakh society. He did not build a palace or buy an expensive car. He could still like many, but chose a different path, and he died, wrote one social media user. My father is also a ranger, wrote another one. He was injured during a similar fight with poachers and nearly died. What punishment did they get? Nothing. They are free. Some rangers complained in private that they risked their lives to catch poachers, but often the only punishment the criminals got was just a fine. Rangers also whispered among each other about cases when someone high up would arrive to hunt, and how they had to pretend they did not see them. This time, Kazakh authorities say that they will find the perpetrators and punish them. Failure to do so would only encourage poachers to continue hunting. Yelen Naglev was going to turn 53 at the end of this month. He was an honest man who never betrayed his principles. said his friend and colleague Zonit Tensik Beef. On social media, there is a growing demand to give him a state award posthumously. Some officials have already supported the call, and even this would only add to the feeling of injustice. Some say, in a country where the prestige of your work is weighed against the power you hold, a ranger's job ranks quite low among government agencies. The government, as well as the people, rarely notice protectors of wildlife until they get killed. A poacher has been ordered to watch the Disney film Bambi repeatedly after he was convicted of illegally killing hundreds of deer. Missouri hunter David Barry, Jr., must view the film at least once a month during his year-long sentence. He was arrested in August along with two family members for killing the deer, taking their heads and leaving their bodies to rot. Prosecutors said, it is reportedly one of the biggest poaching cases in Missouri history, on top of the jail sentence for the illegal deer hunting. Judge Robert George ordered Barry Jr. to view the Walt Disney movie Bambi, with the first viewing being on or before December 24,
2018,
and at least one such viewing each month thereafter. During his spell in prison, the 1,942 cartoon about woodland creatures shows a hunter kill the mother of eponymous deer character Bambi. A month-long investigation, spanning several states, led to the arrest of Barry Jr., his father David Barry, Sr., and his brother Kyle Barry, according to local newspaper, the Springfield Newsletter. While the total number of deer taken illegally is unknown, Lawrence County's conservation agent Andy Barnes said it could be several hundred. Barry Jr. received a year-long sentence in Lawrence County Prison after pleading guilty to illegally taking wildlife. He has also been sentenced to a 120-day term in Barton County Prison for a firearms probation violation, and both he and his father had their hunting privileges revoked for life by the Missouri Conservation Commission. A popular tourist attraction has become the latest Chinese company to show solidarity with Hua Wai's chief finance officer, Meng Wanzhou, who was arrested in Canada on 1 December. Shannon Mountain Scenic Park in eastern Henan Province said it would waive the $9.65 ticket fee for anyone carrying a Huawei phone. Ms. Meng, who was given bail in Canada, faces extradition to the United States on charges of breaking Iran sanctions. Her case has upped tensions with China. U.S. Huawei phones should grant photos on the mountain, a notice on the Shannon Park's social media account said. We wish friends around the world who support Huawei success in bliss. The offer would last until 29 December, the South China Morning Post reported, but it was met with some criticism among China's social media users, who claimed it was discriminatory. Huawei phone owners are being offered other enticements too. They can get a 20% discount at a bar in Beijing. Seen in Beijing, bring a Huawei phone and get 20% off. Similar to this story, we covered yesterday https://t.co.kxl1ipqlpic, twitter.com/sokrilov, end of Twitter post by @lushinji. At least one firm has threatened to penalize anyone buying Apple products. A few days ago, Manpada Shenzhen, based LED display manufacturer, offered subsidies to any employees buying Huawei phones. It also pledged to fine anyone who bought an Apple iPhone. United States prosecutors A legend is mine.
46.
You've the Huawei subsidiary called Skycom to evade sanctions on Iran between 2009 and 2014. They also allege she publicly misrepresented Skycom as being a separate company from Huawei, and that she deceived banks about the true relationship between the two companies. Ms. Meng, who is the daughter of Huawei's founder, has denied any wrongdoing and said she will contest the allegations. Life of Huawei's high-flying heiress. The United States has been investigating the Chinese telecoms giant, the world's second largest smartphone maker.